Well, welcome back to the Mini Pinzgauer build series. This is part 15. Over the last few years of working on this thing, it's mainly been getting welded on and fabricated in my shop. I haven't been able to off-road with it until recently, so I'm pretty excited. In the first 5 minutes of the video, we're just going to be cruising this thing around, fully locked in six-wheel drive, trying it out and see how it does off-road. I know I've been excited about actually using it finally, and most of my subscribers have too, so kick back and enjoy the video. A little bit later in the series here, we will actually paint it and work on the bed, cover that up, and a few other nice little odds and ends, so enjoy the video.
So in the last video, I asked people what they thought about what color. Not many people like the brown. That's fine. It's kind of finished for me, but a lot of people like tan and even more liked green. So my brother at Olympic Overland donated 6 cans of this camo green paint for the project. So we're gonna start spraying some paint on this thing. Hopefully it just doesn't start raining soon. All right, I kind of already missed the brown, but last video I gave people some options to vote on brown, tan, or green, and green seemed to be the most picked color. Camouflage people wanted, but I don't want to buy extra paint. So I kind of like the brown, but gave that option, so time to go. We'll be right back. Got a few updates on the mini pins that I didn't really want to film the whole process of because it was trial and error. Got the CV working better. I took out this whole pulley system here, the CV, and removed the spring, tried in a few different adjustment locations. Finally ended up sanding down the spring so it was a little softer. I also went through the drive pulley here and added some weight to all these CV weights here so it would engage at a lower RPM. So fix that up. Take you around the other side of this thing, show a few more improvements. So relocated the throttle pull so it's direct. I still need to pull apart the engine, pull off the governor. Got it kind of loaded with the spring right now. We'll have to drop under here so I can show you this. Got a choke pull. Basically, it wasn't very convenient. You had to like come over here or through the bed and click on the choke. Super inconvenient. So I ordered this part. Really hard to see in here. So I ordered that part in there as a Honda part number for a manual choke pull. Here's the part number. And basically it sets it up so you can have a cable choke pull. So we're gonna put a cable choke on here and hopefully relocate the key switch to the driver's area. We'll make it a lot easier, more convenient. All right, so the Pinzgauer has been tarped and sitting outside my shop for about 2 months now. Had a lot of other things going on in here between mini bike projects, a lot of different fab work, and I swapped out the axle my Suzuki carry to a rear locking differential. Now this thing's back in here. We're on the home stretch here. I'm looking forward to finishing up. So the center cover's been off for accessing stuff like shocks, drivetrain, and engine. I rolled this in a previous video. This is gonna be the main bed cover. I do need to actually cut it down, narrow it up a little bit with a handheld plasma, but what we really need to do is cut out some little tabs on the CNC. We're going to do that next here. I also have to build an engine cover, rewire the ignition, a few other things like that. So let's head over to the CNC and cut out those tabs next.
So now that I got that removable panel for the drivetrain suspension, we're gonna jump over to the engine cover. Because the engine actually sits higher than the bed, we're gonna have to make a little bump up just to clear it. So we're gonna work on an engine cover next. Oh, and the original Pinzgauers actually do have a little bump up for the engine in the bed as well. Let's get started. Well, getting pretty close to getting this thing finished up. I think one more episode and might be finished, at least to my standards, what I want to have finished. So next episode, we got some pretty cool little modifications, some finishing touches on here. And that ignition and stuff like that was all just temporary, so I can start and operate it. I actually have a little gauge panel I want to build for this thing with a better ignition. So hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. If you're not subscribed, consider subscribing and click that notification bell. I found that most of my subscribers don't really get notified when my new videos come out, so that would help me out. If you guys watch them when the videos are posted, YouTube will recommend the videos more. Till next time, take care. Here, a rooster in the background. All right.